Okay, let's try this again. Maybe. Okay, hello, I'm Alex from AP Ink. It is storming outside, so it might affect my connection. I hope maybe not, but I'm just saying. So I've got a piece of cardboard here that I'm going to be drawing on. I kind of have an idea on what I want to draw, but grab a reference or your imagination and draw with me. I've got a B pencil that I'm going to be sketching with. It's unfortunate because I like kind of like how that arm came out, but I need to push all of this down. Okay, so really quick, so I kind of have a reference to go off of. Just looking up a reference really quick. I was trying to think, where do birds keep their feet when they're in flight? So it looks like a lot of them, I guess, have their feet like just straight back. Maybe it's obvious, but I was trying to think if they tuck them in, like up against their body when they're in flight. Or maybe it depends on the bird. Because here it looks like the bird has tucked its feet. I don't know. That's what it looks like. Because it's the only animal I can think of that it actually exists that flies. I know there's like flying fish and flying squirrels, but they can't actually like flap. Well, I can't say about flying fish, but like flying squirrels can't flap their wings, I don't think, and take off. Okay, I think I'm going to go with that. I'm just going to erase the parts where I shouldn't draw, do the line art so I don't get confused. Okay, so I'm going to use a 0.6 fineliner. Okay, I'm going to give that a minute to dry. And then I'll erase the pencil. I will be right back. Okay, I'm going to use a kneaded eraser to erase the pencil. Okay, so for the base color, I'm going to use Artist's Loft Teen Crimson. Okay, so really quick, I'm gonna put little tick marks where the segments of the belly scales are gonna go. Okay, I'm gonna, just so they don't get lost, I'm gonna go over those pencil tick marks with the same 0.06 fine liner. I'm not gonna go all the way across. I'm actually gonna try to hide these tick marks when I get into the next part. Just want to make sure that pencil is gone. So from here, I'm gonna use colored pencil to add more detail. I'm thinking for this one, I'm actually gonna use brown to help add shadows and highlights. Now, granted, because the red is so dark and the color of the cardboard helps to deepen that color, some of these colors might not work. Okay, I'm gonna try. Don't know if either of these are going to show up any different. I got burnt umber and sepia. I think I'll use sepia and put the burnt umber back. Okay, so I'm going to try. Actually, really quick, I want to try a lighter tone. Okay, I don't know if it's going to stand out, but I've got light salmon, goldenrod, burnt ochre, and sepia. I'm going to try the sepia and the burnt umber or burnt ochre for the shadows, and then the goldenrod and light salmon for highlights. These two might be too close, so I might have to switch out the light salmon for something else. I think I'm gonna start with the shadows first. I think the red is too dark for this to really show up. This is sepia. I think this burnt ochre is kind of pointless. You can even see that. Okay, for the highlights, I've got light salmon and goldenrod. First, I'm gonna sharpen the light salmon, and then I'm gonna get into trying to add some highlights. Not sure if the shadows are really standing out at all. At least for the camera. Okay, light salmon. Okay, so goldenrod. Okay. The belly, the fin here, and like the membrane on the wings. Okay, first, I think I'm gonna do the nails with light salmon. Fill them in with light salmon. Okay, now I'm gonna do the fin, the wings, and the belly with light salmon. Just do a light coat or fill it in really light. Okay, from there, I'm gonna do goldenrod and sepia and try to create kind of a ombre effect. Going back over with the goldenrod. And then going over all of that with the light salmon again. Okay, I'm gonna go over that again. with the goldenrod and the sepia just to sharpen up those colors just a little bit. Okay, from here, the belly, I'm going to add the sepia and then the goldenrod. So I'm going to use the sepia to try to hide the tick marks that I made. Okay, and then I'm going to use the goldenrod to kind of tint the bottom that might not be dark enough. Okay, I'm going to switch to the burnt ochre instead to kind of tint or shade the bottom of the scales. Okay, I'm gonna go over with the light salmon to kind of blend that, but also to darken the first layer. Okay, now I'm going to go over the sepia and the burnt ochre again. Okay, I'm gonna go over with the sepia, just really light, to try and add some shadow to the light salmon. Add some shadow to the claws. Okay, the eye. I'm gonna do light salmon first. The nose, I'm just going to fill in with the sepia. And then I added just a little bit to the eye. Okay, I think just for a little bit extra detail, I'm going to use a white gel pen. Okay, so give you a closer look. I'm not too sure about this one. I probably could have chosen different colors to tone it with. But that's the overall look of it. I am going to leave this stream here. I want to thank anybody who watched either during or after. I do plan on being back tomorrow about 6:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time for anybody who would like to join me. Other than that, enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye.